That's very interesting. Let's go closer. And apparently, a friend of mine who's sitting watching this show says that it could easily be a grey-headed gull, which is a gull that we find inland in South Africa, so it's not always by the sea. And he says he's seen them here before. This will be a very first sighting for me. That will be very special indeed. Let's move a little bit further around here and have another look. I wonder what it's eating. It looks like something that has unfortunately dropped dead on the side. Can you believe it? It's a gull. Oh, and it's eating a catfish. That's a dead catfish. And remember I was telling you about those starlings and how pretty they are in the light? Well, there they are. There are the starlings, and they're sitting with a gull. All the way here, miles and miles and miles from the sea. Can you believe it? I'm really excited by that, I must say. I'll show you a picture of it once we've had a look at it eating that dead catfish. Doesn't look a very delicious catfish to eat, does it? No. Yuck. A catfish, of course, isn't tasty at the best of times. But now it's been rotting in the sun for a little while. So it's really not tasty in the slightest. You find all the gulls in my book. Here are all the gulls, lots and lots of them here. And the reason that it doesn't have a grey head like that, of course, is that it is not breeding. It is not in its sort of breeding plumage. So this is not the time of the year that they breed, and that's why he's got a plain head with no grey on it. Isn't that very special? Okay, everybody, we're going to say goodbye to you all the way in South Carolina.